We just want to say that we want to, as a ministry, begin to go much further and deeper in prayer and worship, and this is our breakthrough month that we have established for everybody to get their full breakthrough. That's their refilling. Everybody just say refilling.
Refilling.
Amen. I don't mean getting filled initially. I mean a what? Re. Amen. Your cup running over. How many believe your cup can run over?
Yes.
To the point that you can't contain it?
Yes, yes, yes. Amen.
Jesus said, if you believe on me, as the scripture has said, out of your what belly shall flow rivers of living water. We had Sister Margo up here last week, and she kind of set the stage for this overflow thing. I ought to call her back, but a perfect example, because she received the Holy Spirit in such measure that on her way back home after the 4-hour vigil, she had to pull off. She lost control. She felt like she couldn't maneuver her automobile even until the anointing lifted. I want to see everybody drunk in the Spirit. Some say, amen. How many want to be drunk in the Spirit? Come to the point where you can just ignore all of the observations and what people say, what people think, how you look, how you act. Amen. This is the thing that I believe is necessary in order for God to fully manifest his glory, his promises, his provisions. I believe, y'all might not believe as I do, that the criteria for God's blessings to be fully manifested in our lives, you have to be filled to overflowing. Unhindered move with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.
Yes.
That's what I'm believing, that's what I'm seeking, and that's what I'm practicing now. How many can say praise the Lord?
Praise
amen.
The Lord.
I want to, Sister Margo, just come in just for a second. Are you still full? We want some people that's really filled to the brink. They inspire me. That's what I'm talking about. Now she's educated. She probably got more than all of us in here. She's educated, but look how she's acting and running. She's excited about what God has done for her. Hallelujah. I believe if God does something for you, I believe you ought to show some sign. Hey. Said, shall follow him and believe in my name.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you so much. I am so full. And I want you to know, since a week ago, when I gave you just a fraction, I went on Tuesday for a thyroid biopsy. And at 5:02 on Friday, the doctor called me and said, that it was benign.
It was a 2-hour stretch. She was calling on the Lord. Hallelujah. God gave her overflow. Hey. Oh. She lost control. Still out of control. He's still working on her. That overflow is still moving on her. Hallelujah. How many know God is a God of overflow? More. How many want your cup to run over? Oh, praise Him. When you talk in tongues uncontrollably, that's what I'm talking about. Sharabahurabahasata. Lay a hold on my heart, Shabtai. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right, we're going to... I think we're going to have a little season where we're just going to lay hands for everybody to get your breakthrough. I mean, you talk in tongues better than you ever talked before. You prophesy and magnify God more than you ever did before. This little lady here surprises me. Just sit up on your feet and praise God for your breakthrough. She ain't the Sister Shirley that we knew while back. She's a different Sister Shirley now. Is that right? She's Sister Shirley. Hallelujah. The Sister Breakthrough Shirley. Come on now out of this aisle, just begin to praise God. This is the Breakthrough Shirley now. So let me join some Shirley. Shete Fasamo Hokarama. Feel to the overflow. Feel to the overflow. Feel to the overflow. Feel to the overflow. Feel my cup, Lord. Let it overflow. Hey, hey. We got a lot of overflow people here. Shout out my heart. She got something you want to say. Say, what you got? What you got? It's gotta be God. You can't have to pull them up here for them to say anything. Is you trying to take the mic back from me? I got something to say.
Glory, hallelujah. Lord, I thank you, Father. Glory, hallelujah. I cannot thank my God enough. This may not be nothing to you all, but glory, hallelujah, it's a lot to me. Now, I know y'all, some of y'all know my son. Okay, he hadn't seen his kids in 5 years. Now, you know, that's a long time for a father. I'm not saying he's a good father, because he got hang-ups, the wife had hang-ups too. But that's a long time for you not to see your kids.
Yeah, that's right.
I've been coming to church, and I'm telling you, 5 years. I've been praying, I've been asking the Lord. I said, he needs to see his kids. I said, he needs to see his kids. Okay, Thursday morning, I didn't get to come. But glory, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Right about 12:30, the young twin knocked on the door. Woo! I tell you what, I jumped, I shout, I thought, thank God, I love God. I started thanking the Lord. Because, you know, he needed to see his kids, and he got to see that twin. Okay, she went back to Louisiana, so the other two supposed to be up here in about 2 weeks.
Amen.
And his son played basketball too. And he's a good student. They all after him and everything. But I mean, 5 years, I don't think I could have made it if I couldn't see my kids in 5 years. So, you know, I thank God for this church. I thank God for Pastor Hill. I thank God that we got a friend. We got people that's full of the word, and they want you to be full of the word. And I thank God, because when I went back up here, and I sat. And let me tell you, church, when the pastor want us to do things, you know, like praying things that we should do, more of you can come than what's coming. And God knows, hey, you need to come. And I just thank God. And Pastor Hill, I thank the Lord for you. And Sister Hill, I thank you.
Well, she got her breakthrough last Saturday. That's when Sister Taylor can tell that. Now, I can tell it like she told me. Okay, so Sister Wayne, you come, and Sister Derek, I'm trying to explain it a little better.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bet you some of y'all are wondering what's going on, but it's miracles are going on. Miracle signs and wonders are following. He said these signs are going to follow those that believe. So when we come together, God is working miracles. I shared with some when we went out of town. I've been feeling, since I've been praising the Lord and praying and the exercise, feeling like I was telling some 20 years younger. So I did what I guess a 20-year younger person would do, attempted to do, because I tried to jump backwards on a truck to get to wave in the float in the parade. But that was not wisdom. So we got to need to pray for wisdom, because that was not wisdom, because I injured something. I didn't know if I had broke a rib or what I did, because for 2 whole weeks I was in pain. But I was still praising the Lord and rubbing and believing God for healing to manifest, which it has. But talking with my daughters, and didn't want, you might need to go to the doctor and see what you did, so you know how to pray or what. So I ended up at the hospital because I couldn't see the doctor. But I have a praise report that I want to share. You know, when you go in with chest pains, the first thing they want to do is check your heart. And I have a history in my family. My father has a heart, something in his chest. They put my oldest sister passed with an enlarged heart. So I have a history, so that's the first thing they do. But the doctor came back after running these tests, taking my blood. And I'm like, wait a minute, am I donating blood to somebody or something? You know, but anyway, they came back and he says, I have good news for you. Because I'm like, did I break something? He says, your heart is the heart of a person, I don't know if he said 40 years younger or 40 years old. Either one of them, I'm not 40 years old. And I'm like, I knew it wasn't anything wrong, but that's a testimony, you know, that how my heart has been restored. I've been saying I feel 20 years younger. I feel 20 years younger. So God is doing a work in my body, in my spirit, as I go forth and praise Him and worship Him and thank Him and put these requests. We're putting requests before Him. He's working them out. Sister Shirley didn't share that with anybody, but those were part of her prayers, and God is answering prayers. So this is a time to jump in. Whatever your prayer request, whatever your need, take it to the Lord in prayer. And I just thank God for, I didn't have any broken ribs or anything. I could have for all of that going backwards, but God kept me, you know. And my husband said he didn't know it was anything wrong with me till that night when I would lay down. Something will go in the back of me. But all that's gone now, praise God. And He's given me wisdom. And so we pray for wisdom as we go forth and seeking Him and praising Him. And I thank God for this ministry. Hallelujah. How He brought Pastor Deborah back, encouraging us to pray. Pastor Hill has always been talking about prayer and praying the Word. And I thank God for the opportunity to come and pray the Word, get stronger in the Word. Like the sister said about, he's had me to, instead of just the music, because I was loving and exercising music, to listen to the Word. I have listened to the Word and repeat the Word. The Word, when you hear it over and over, it gets in your spirit, you know. So those that say they don't like to read, if you got some CDs, some tapes or something, listen to that Word, repeat that Word, and let that Word get deep inside you. Because what you put in is going to come out when you need it, or for somebody else. So God bless you, and thank you.
She's one of the 5 o'clock. Prayer warriors, and she's the one that stays with us the 2 hour from 5 to 7 on Thursday. So we just believe that everybody in this church is headed for a breakthrough. And I believe that's the conditions for God to fulfill every promise. Every promise. When you are full, hallelujah. My sister Deborah, you come. Last week she was praying and God would do a new thing on Saturday. And I didn't know how it was going to happen, but Sister Deb, you come and tell us about it.
Okay, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. We pray for a spirit of acceptance and not rejection. Amen. But I do believe I have something I'd like to share, and I promise that I will not be long. I want to present a challenge to us as a church with continuing our breakthrough. I'm not going to start praying and carrying on. I know we got to get up out of here. But the Lord revealed this to me last night, this prayer challenge. And how many are familiar with the Jabez prayer?
Yeah.
Amen. I feel led to challenge us as a church for 21 days to pray the Jabez prayer out loud. Every day for 21 days, and that will be give or take a day until June 25th. And I don't want us to just memorize it, but let it be a part of our life. Let's be connected with that. And if someone can put up 1 Chronicles 4:10, and you may want to write that down, that's the prayer of Jabez. And I'd like for us to do that out loud, do it as a routine, do it at breakfast, in the shower, in the car. When you get a break at work, I'd like for us to pray this out loud and let's see what the Lord will do within 21 days. Does that sound exciting? It says, oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, and that your hand might be with me, and that you would keep me from evil, that I may not cause pain. How many can use the blessings of the Lord indeed? And enlarging our coast, let's take that spiritually. You know, you need God to give you the capacity to accept and receive his word. Amen. We need God to give us the capacity to pray and to wait on him. That means increasing our mind, our soul, our spirit, our intellect. We need God to give us an increase to do those things. I never take for granted, I try not to, that I can just pray automatically. But if the Holy Spirit prays through me, come on, somebody. Amen. I'll be that vessel that he can flow through. So enlarging our territory and increasing our coast, let's take that to a spiritual. God, I want more. And we can't just decide, well, I'm going to decide in 2 weeks I'll be hungry for God. I don't know about you, but I like that old school say, put it in me to be hungry for more of you. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Put it down in my belly. Oh, glory to God. A hunger for your word, a hunger for prayer, a hunger for faithfulness, everything that pertains to life and godliness. God, put it down in me. And if you put it in me, glory, hallelujah, I'll go after your heart. I'll go after, glory to God, your word. I'll go after you, God. I'll pursue you. If you put it down in me, in my flesh, I don't desire. There's no good thing in my flesh. My flesh don't desire to pray, but if you put it down in me, God, hey, if you put it down in my spirit, man, if you put it down in my inner man, I will want more of you, and that I want, and that you put in me, that's what I will pursue. I'm not going to go through everything that the Lord gave me, but I do want to encourage you with this, and I think it will go in line with what has happened this morning with the athletes and the achievements of the young people. I want to encourage us to cry out loud. Somebody say, cry out loud. My scripture reference is Joshua chapter 6, verses 1 through 5. And in these particular scriptures, long story short, God is telling Joshua to cry out loud. Glory to God. And as a church, be encouraged to cry out loud. In other words, lift your voice. Cry out loud to the Lord. And in this long story short, we know God can really talk. I don't know why people can't hear him, because he talks. He wrote 65 books and still didn't put everything in it. So he talks. Glory to God. He's a talking God. Hallelujah. I love him for it. But long story short, most of us have heard this story, how God led Joshua to tell the people to shout out loud that the walls may fall. And the Lord is saying to you today, if you cry out loud, glory to God, I don't know what you're going through today. I don't know what you're facing, but if you learn to cry out loud, walls will fall. Things will crush, amen, in your life. Glory to God. So I want to encourage us. Let's go to one scripture. We'll read it. Hebrews 5:7. And when I say cry out loud, I mean pray out loud. We really need to pray out loud. I'm going to connect this with sports here in a minute. But if you want reference, somebody say, just give me the Bible. Tell me where that's in the Bible. I'm not doing it till I see it in the Bible. Well, turn to Hebrews 5:7. I got something for you. Because most of us cry out, I want to be like Jesus. I want more Jesus. Amen. Let's see what Jesus did in Hebrews 5:7. Can I get a reader, please? Pastor Dan.
He was heard and that he feared.
Amen.
Read that again, brother. This scripture is talking about Jesus.
Yes.
What is it saying about Jesus?
It says, who in the days of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and supplications with strong crying and tears unto him, that was able to save him from death and was heard. And that he feared.
Come on, we're talking about Jesus, and we want to. I'm gonna pull out my Baptist techniques. We're gonna look at the A part of that scripture. You know, the Baptists have the A part and the B part. We're gonna look at the A part. Who in the days of his flesh, talking about when Jesus was on the earth, come on, when he had offered up prayers and supplication, he did it how? He did it how? And what? And tears. Come on, saints. We're too desert in our prayer life. I got in my spirit this morning. We're barren in our prayer life. We need some moisture. We need some watering. We need that refreshing, right? Glory to God. When the tears flow, when you think about how good he is, hey, when the tears flow, just loving him, hallelujah, not tears of sorrow and grief, but when I think about his goodness and all he's done for me, hallelujah, I begin to cry out, thank you, Jesus. I'm calming down because I'm not going to stay up here long. Hallelujah. It brings tears. And some of us are dry. Come on. Glory to God. We need, hallelujah, godly sorrow that will lead to repentance. Come on here. Thank you, Jesus. My illustration on praying out loud, I'm almost done. And athletes, you can help me. Sometimes I do like football. And when my team is... my team is winning. I don't know, I'm gonna say winning, but when I'm watching my team and they have the ball, you can tell I don't know much. I'm just kind of just work with the sister. I'm just when my team has the ball, this part I do know, and they're running for a touchdown. Come on. I don't sit there and say, I'ma start hollering as soon as he made that touchdown. You don't either. Oh, thank you, God. When your team is running towards the touchdown, you are hollering while he has the ball. Can he get tackled, right? I've seen them trip each other. He might not make it. But you don't wait till he makes it, right? While he has the ball. talking to Pastor Riz. And give God some praise. Hallelujah. Glory. God. And the Spirit of the Lord for this house is saying, we need breakthrough. Don't think Pastor Hill read the book and say, oh, that sounds good. He's hearing from the Spirit of the Lord that for this month, oh, glory to God, we need a breakthrough, glory to Jesus, in our prayer lives. If you don't need it, I need a breakthrough in my prayer life, glory to God. I want to pray in the Spirit like it might be my last time. Glory to God. I told somebody if I could, I'd roll all over the front of this church. Desperate situation, you sure enough need to cry out. Don't go church mother on you like Sister Dorothy, baby. You need to cry out. Of our sorrows, of our lack. We won't find out what's on the other side until we cry out. Are you with me? You got to cry out to see a breakthrough, to see a deliverance. And I feel in my spirit, everybody's not there. Now I'm gonna go old school Deborah Moore. Some of us like our sin. Who's gonna be my worst security to walk me out of here? We like it. So we're not crying out. Does that mean I might have to give up? Brother, sneak around. I might have to give up my nicotine. Come on, I'm being right. I might have to give up immorality. So we're not opening our minds. Oh, yeah. We can read you like Hooked on Phonics. Hallelujah. But for those of us, come on, church, that want a breakthrough, glory to God, that want to see a deliverance, if you don't need it, your children might need it. If your children don't need it, your children's children might need it. For those of us, glory to God, who want a breakthrough in this church, come on, say, for those of us, many are the affliction of the righteous. that I feel is connecting. When you know the strong man, Jesus said you can go in and steal his goods when you take the strong man. And there are two strong men I feel that's being territorial even in our nation, and that's the spirit of pride and jealousy. Pride and jealousy network. Those are two strong men. You have to know the strong men and how they network. We call the devil dumb, but he knows the network. He has an organization structure. And one is pride and jealousy. And we need to pray. How many can say amen? It's prayer time, saints. Amen. Let's come out even on the fourth Saturdays, the Tuesdays and Thursdays. And the Monday nights, we need to cry out. We need it. Yeah. Amen. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Those that would like hands laid on you, it won't take long. We all fired up. Those that would like to have hands laid on you for your breakthrough, just come on down right now. Sister Deborah's going to come. The ministers are going to come. Your hand, we're not going to tear. Come Monday night to tear. Tuesday morning to tear. Thursday morning. Today we're going to lay hands on you. Hallelujah. Amen. That breakthrough is going to happen when we lay hands on you. Come on, ministers. Hallelujah. To sing. We're going to have to move into the communion. We're going to prepare. But we want to just say that on Tuesdays and Thursdays, as well as Monday night, we're going to begin to keep pushing for plug for the breakthrough on Monday night. Monday night is going to be a breakthrough night. We're just going to pray everybody through. Do you get your joy? Do you get your victory? Do you overflow in the anointing? We're going to give over on Monday night, Tuesday morning, Thursday morning. You, amen. We're going to do that the entire month of June. Amen. All of the information, the material that we're meditating on, we will be able to share that with you as well. You do want to get all of the material that we are meditating. Amen. God bless you. Brother Daniel is going to come. We're prepared to, we want you to prepare your hearts after the communion to bless Brother Daniel. And this is the time of year that we usually do something special for him, for all of his services. Sunday school, diligently, every Sunday throughout the year. Then he's driving the bus, and that takes, he goes out on Saturdays and recruit and line the children up for pickup on Saturday. Brother Al also assists him. And that's a huge, huge, huge responsibility. This is a time of year that he has set aside to go and get some rest and to get some relaxation and to enjoy. And we just want to be a blessing. Those of you could do $50 or $100 or whatever you can do, $25. I think it would be, amen, in good soil, planting seeds in good soil. And we want to be a blessing to him. Without his commitment to pick up those children, you know, we wouldn't have the outreach that we have. And the outreach is expanding. Driving that bus, making 2 and 3 loads on Sunday, then returning them back. That is a huge responsibility. So we just want to show through our giving today our love and our support for him. Amen. Praise God. We're not able to pay everybody, you know, each week salary, but I think once in a while we can do something that means something for those that put forth special effort and make, amen, a lot of commitments and sacrifices for the ministry.
All right. Amen. Let us all stand. Apostle Paul said in 1 Corinthians 11:23, "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, Take, eat. This is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Let's eat the broken body. "After the same manner, also he took the cup when he had supped, saying, This cup is the New Testament in my blood. Do this to ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he come." Let us drink. Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Amen. The broken body and the shed blood. Someone give the Lord praise. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
While Pastor is signing his check, I've already given mine another offer. I just wanted to add, he mentioned this is for Brother Donnell, and it's for Brother Donnell and Sister Candy. So many times the women are left out, and I couldn't miss that opportunity to say that. She works in this ministry as well. No offense, Brother Williams. What Pastor said was true, but often the women are left in the background. So Sister Candy, it's for you too.
Well, she want to rake me over coals, doesn't she? All right. Well, she got that in on me. I'll get her back. All right. Sister Candy, we appreciate you a whole lot. And we know that Brother Donnell is going to, you his queen, so I knew that it's in the good hands when it's in the hand of the king. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy. To the only wise God be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Appreciate Sister Devon. Amen. But she sneaked out. I real message is, I mean, she sneaked it in. She was scared. Hey, hallelujah. All right, God bless you. Make sure you come this direction before you head the other direction. Jesus. Let's dance out of this place on fire for the Lord.